Hello students, this lecture is part of Quantitative Aptitude 2018 course. The link to the complete course is available in the description. Hello students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. So today onwards I'm going to start the data interpretation series in which I'm going to share some really important questions for the RBI Grade B and the other related exams like IBPS, RRB Scale 2, Bank of India Grade of such exam, NABARD Grade. So the data interpretation part is common for all. So today I'm going to share the question that we have seen in the RBI Grade B 2018 evening slot. So it was there in the evening slot on 16th of August 2018. So really important question. Five questions were there. Before starting, the set, I want to tell you that most important thing here. Before starting the data interpretation, learn the tables up to 50. 40 or 40 is enough. Learn the table up to 40. This thing is really important. If you want to ask me, sir, what is the most important tip for data interpretation sets? The calculation speeds. You can improve your calculation speed only by learning the tables up to 40, squares, and even the fractions. Really important. So let's start. This was a table. Some of the informations are given, some of the informations were not given. There are six schools, PQ, RST, U. Total number of students were given in case of Q, S, and U. The ratio of boys and girls is given in some of the schools, not all. And the passing and failing ratio in exams, that is given in two schools. And number of students who got the scholarship is given in four schools only. So here, the important point, what you can calculate from the given table. I think the only thing that you can calculate here is that the ratio of boys and girls is 12 and 13. So the quick way to find out the number of boys and girls is like, what is the exact number of boys and girls is there? So 12 plus 13 is equal to 25. Now you need to divide 1500 by 25. You need to divide 1500 by 25. What it's going to be? 1500 by 25. So 25 fours a 100, right? 25 fours a 100 multiply by 15. It comes out. You need to do it in your mind. So it is 60. So the number of boys comes out to be, the number of boys and number of girls comes out to be 720. This one and the remaining is this one. 13 multiplied by 6 and it comes out to be 780. So 720 plus 780 is equal to 1500. So that's how you need to calculate using the questions. So this is the question number one. If 20, we are talking about the school U, in which the number of boys and girls we have already calculated 720 and 780. So the number of boys is 720 and number of girls is 780. Now, if 20% of the boys in school U got the scholarship, if the 20% of the boys, so what is the 20% of the boys? Total number of boys is 720. 720 ka 20% you need to calculate. You can do it really easily actually. So how to find the 20% of this one? Just tell me. 72 multiplied by 2. I'm not asking you to remember the table of 72, but that will be great if you can do. But anyways, 72 multiplied by 2, do it in your mind. 7 to the 14, so it is 140. 2 to the 4, so do it in your mind, it is 144. So 144 boys got the scholarship, and how many girls didn't get the scholarship? So total number of scholarships, students who got the scholarship is 20%. So what is 20% of 1500? That is 300. So 300 students got the scholarship. Out of them, how many boys are there? 144. So how many? What is the remaining number? 156 girls got the scholarship. If 156 girls got the scholarship, how many? What is the total number of girls? It is 780. So total number of girls is 780, and 156 got the scholarship, and the remaining are the number of girls that didn't get any scholarship, right? So what is the exact number? This one must be like, four is the last one, it should be 624. So this is the correct answer. Are you getting it? That was really simple, actually. Really simple. Still, many students told me that the exam was difficult and all, but this is the kind of question that were asked. 60% of the students who passed in the exam in school queue are boys. So let's talk about the school queue. So 1500 students are there, 8 pass, 7 fails. Just what is 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. So that's how we calculate. You need to do the ratios, right? So it is 800 plus 700, total number of students who passed the exam is 800, and 700 students failed the exam. So ratio is 8 and 7. You need to find the sum of 8 and 7. It is 15, and divide 1500 by 15. So the value of 1x is equal to 100. So 8 multiplied by 100 is equal to 800. 7 multiplied by 100 is equal to 700. So 60% of the students who passed are boys. Who pass the exam in queue are boys. So 800 students pass the exam. So first of all, we are talking about a student who passed the exam. So 60% are boys. So 60% are boys. So it is 480 are boys and rest are girls. 480 are boys and 320 are girls. So out of 800 students who pass the exam, 480 are boys, because 60% are boys, and remaining 320 are girls. Now, the percentage of girls who pass the exam is 80%. So 320 girls actually passed this exam. 320 girls are actually passed the exam. And the percentage of girls who pass the exam is 80%. 320 is 80%. What is 100%? 100 divided by 80. So it is 4. So 400 is the total number of girls in the school. Total number of girls in the school. So you need to find the number of boys in the school. Really simple, actually. So total number of student is 1500. The number of girls is 400. This was the number of girls. So this was the number of girls who passed the exam. While 80% of the girls passed the exam, 100% are 400. So total number of students are 1500. So rest 400 are girls. So 1100 are boys. So 1100 is the correct answer. Really simple. So this much concept you need to implement here. Now next question: if the difference between the boys and girls in the school P is 180, then the how many number of students are there? What's the number of students in the school P? So in the school P, 7:9 is given. Whenever such questions are there, see, you need to understand the concept of ratio to do this question. So we can 7:9 is given, the boys and girls. We can assume the value of 1 is equal to x, right? So the value of 2x is given as 180, because if the difference between boys and girls is 180, so this 2, the difference here is 2, this 2, 2x we can say, sorry, is 180. What is the value of x? Is equal to 90. So what is the number of boys here? 7 multiplied by 90. What is the number of girls here? 9 multiplied by 90. So 630 here and 810 here. 630 and 810. So then how many students who didn't get the scholarship? Now find the total number of students. This is the number of girls and this is the number of boys. So need to find out the sum of them. So it is 1440 students are there. Out of them, 65% got the scholarship, and they are asking who didn't get the scholarship. 35% didn't get the scholarship. That is actually really easy. 1440 multiplied by 35 divided by 100. So you can do that easily, actually. So can you do that easily? Yes, you can, actually. So the simple 7 twos are 14, and then 1 is there. 7 are 49, and then 504. This is 504 is a correct answer. You don't need to, you know, learn all the tables up to 72 and 75. You can do it in your mind. You can do it in your brain. The next question, if the number of students who receive the scholarship in school R, we are talking about school R. If the number of students who got the scholarship in school R is 540, school R, okay. 60% of the students got the scholarship and 540 students got the scholarship. If 540 is 60%, what is 100%? Simple, 540 multiplied by 100 divided by 60. So that one is pretty easy. So the total number of students is 900. 900 is the total number of students. 20% of the boys. So 900 is the total number of students. And out of them, 4 and 5 ratios are given. So total is 9. So 400 are boys and 500 are girls. And then 20% of the boys in the school receive the scholarship. So for... let's bring it here. So 400 boys are there. Out of them, 20% got the scholarship. 80. Okay. So find out how much percentage of girls receive the scholarship. So the total number of scholarships is 540. Total scholarship is 540. Out of them, boys got 80. Rest 460 girls got 460 scholarships. What is the total number of girls in the school? 500. How many got the scholarship? 460. You need to calculate the percentage. So 460 divided by 500. This is pretty easy. Instead of cutting and all, just multiplied by 22. So it becomes 920 divided by 1000. So it is 92%. Very simple. Simple question. The last question, the fifth question. If 20% of the students who pass the examination in school is, now we are talking about school is. They are not related. One point here is that each school is not related to each other. If 20% of the school, while in exam there was a question, difference between the number of students in the school. I mean, the set in the exam, this is a memory based set. The set in the exam was easier than this set. This set is little more difficult than the real exam. Real exam was easier than this one. If 20% of the students who pass the exam in the school is receive the scholarship. Okay, so if 20% of students who pass examination, so 1800 students are there in the school as 1800 students are there, out of them 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. So it is 1000 students who pass the exam, 549, so 1800, the same rule, it is 200 multiplied by 5 is equal to 1000, and 200 multiplied by 4 is equal to 800. It's too hot here actually. So it is 800 students who failed the exam. If 20% of the students who passed the exam, 20% of the students got the scholarship. So 20% of passed through students, 20% is 200. They got the scholarship. Okay. My writing is bad. They got the scholarship, right? If 120 students, then find the number of girls who receive the scholarship. If 120 boys receive the scholarship, so this is the total number of students who got the scholarship. 200 is this, and 120 boys got the scholarship. The number of girls who got the scholarship is 200 minus 120 is 80. So it should be, I think I did some mistake here in writing that options. The correct answer is yes, it's 80. 80 is the correct answer. 80 is the correct answer. It's not in the options. I think we did some mistake in writing down the options, but 80 is the correct answer. So this is the level of questions that you are going to see in your exams. In exams like RBI Grade B, like Bank of India, Credit Officer, or like any scale 2 level exam, RRB or NABARD level exam, you are going to find such questions. So let's move forward. In case you are facing any difficulty, you can ask your discussion, ask your doubts in the discussion boards. I'll be there for you. This question was pretty easy. I request all of you to learn tables up to 40. And if possible, I have already done a video, a lecture on fractions. You should know how to find the fraction of 13 divided by 43. If I ask you to find the percentage, you should be able to do that. I mean, the approximation answer, you should have an approximate answer. So that's all for today, students. In case you're having any doubt, you can ask me in the discussion board. I'm answering all the doubts on a regular basis. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a very nice day. Bye.